Hey there! You may remember, if you follow my channel, that a while ago I reviewed this pen, a Wahl Eversharp Skyline, but this is the modern remake. So, the Wahl Eversharp company, as far as I know, went bankrupt, stopped making pens, and then a couple of fans took it amongst themselves, took it on themselves to recreate the pen brand, and these pens are the result. Now, Eric saw that, and he thought, well, that's interesting, but apparently the Skyline is one of his favorite pens, but he is very interested in the original vintage Skyline. So he sent me, I'm unwrapping it right now, a vintage Skyline. Now you will see the resemblance here, I'm sure, even down to the slightly pointy curved barrel. Let's have a look at this pen. First of all, Eric, thanks a lot for sending me this pen. I appreciate it. I'm going to cover the parts of this pen, tell what I like about it, what I don't like about it, and then I'll do a writing sample. So let's start at the very top of this pen. You have a very interesting finial, which I like a lot on this one. It's actually the clip, you see, that sort of goes all around. The clip itself, focus. The clip itself, it's kind of nice. Nice and springy, the way I like it. Okay, now we go on. Here you have the cap. The cap has these nice ribs. And then you have the clip, and the clip says Eversharp. And you go on. You have the barrel. The barrel tapers down. And quite low, I think it's quite low, near the bottom is a lever, because these are lever-filled pens. For those of you who don't know what that is, you don't see that a lot of modern pens. There's a rubber sack in the pen, and then there is a lever, and there are various ways the lever works on the inside, but basically what it does is you hook your thumbnail behind that lever there, and you lift it up like that, not too far right now because there's ink in there, but when you do that, the sack on the inside is compressed, sometimes with a J-bar that runs around it, and then when you press that lever, that is going to move. Sometimes that's just a bit of steel that's actually pushed against it. The effect is the same. The sack is compressed. When you put it in the ink bottle and you let go of that lever, then the sack is going to be decompressed, and that creates a vacuum that would then draw some ink. It's a very elegant and simple system that was used quite a lot. Okay, it says, let me see, 1/10 14K gold filled. A 10th 14-karat gold fill, gold filling. That means I'm always confused by that term. I'm sure there's going to be someone out there who's going to correct me in the comments here. But I think it is. It's not. They don't roll the steel over there, but they do something else, and I forgot what. As I said, I always forget what these specific jeweler's terms are. Okay, so. I'm sorry, that probably means that there is gold content on the cap, but it's not solid gold. Let's summarize it as such. Again, someone is going to correct me. You unscrew the pen and you get this, the cap, and then you get this very nice design. Now, I think this is a very nice design because this is almost like a desk pen or a really nice calligraphy dip nib holder. You have this nice tapering that goes down, ends in a fairly pointy end. And then here you also have a tapering that goes to the section and then it flares up. Very pleasant to hold. There are threads, but I don't really feel them. You feel them, but they're not unpleasant. They're not sharp at all. Very pleasant to hold, and as you can see, a very decent size. I would not feel the need to post this pen, but it is possible. Now, this being all metal, it does get a bit top heavy. For me, it's very ergonomic to use it just like that. Okay. Then we have, I'm showing you a close-up here of the the section and the nib. As you can see, the nib says Eversharp. What else does it say? It says 14K, yeah, 14K and Eversharp. A very interesting feed design. This is one that I hadn't seen before. That's quite cool. The nib is very pleasant to use. It's flexy and it's very smooth. So, a really nice pen. Okay, well, I would say there you have it. That's what I can tell you about the pen. What do I like about it? What do I not like about it? Well, with all vintage pens, It's a very personal thing, and I guess that goes for modern pens too. But in this case, this is not your standard black, hard rubber, slightly boring pen. This is something else. A very interesting design, and I can see why these pens are popular. Clearly, in a future shootout, I'll have to compare these two pens, right? The modern versus the old one. But for now, I was very pleasantly surprised. So, I like that. I like the design. I like the looks. I like the section. It's a very pleasant pen to hold. As I said, very ergonomic. All very cool. What do I not like about it? Well, to be honest, I couldn't really find anything I don't like about it. Sure, the color is a very typical green, but somewhat odd green maybe. But if you, I mean, there are other colors available. I like this green. I think it's pretty cool. It's a bit of an army green color. I like that. Seems to work well. The nib is smooth, it's flexy, it feels well. I don't see anything that is not to like about the pen, to be honest. I've really tried. I guess you could say that the lever is maybe a bit low, but it's nice and flush with the barrel. I really can't find anything I don't like. I'm sorry. I just think this is an excellent pen. So there you have it. Let's take a couple of measurements before we do the writing sample. It's not the smallest of pens. Capped, it's 133 millimeters. Uncapped, I think it's fairly long, especially for a vintage pen. There we go. It's 126 millimeters. Section diameter at the narrowest point is about 8 millimeters. Well, no, it's about 9 millimeters. At the widest point, about 10. And then we have the weight of the pen. It comes down to 20 grams inked up. So there you have it. Guys, I hope this was useful. And Eric, thanks a lot for sending me this pen. I really appreciate it. I really like this one. Let's do a writing sample. I hope this was useful. All right, the original Weil Eversharp Skyline. This nib, it's not marked as having a specific grade, but I would say it's something between F and M, so fine and medium. The ink is Montblanc Irish Green, if I remember correctly, and it does definitely look like it. Okay, yeah, sorry guys, I sometimes ink up so many pens to do the reviews that I forget which ink I put in what pen. Also, you have to bear in mind that I'm getting older. So back in the day, everything was better when we had the fountain pen. No, I'm just kidding. But it is hard. If you have 20 pens inked up, it's sometimes hard to recall which ink went in what pen. But I'm pretty sure this is Irish Green. Nice ink. It's one of my favorite greens. Okay, so writing is very smooth, very pleasant. Let's see how well the feed keeps up if we do this a bit faster. Well, no skipping, no skidding, pretty cool. How about wetness? Well, no complaints there. This is a bit of a gusher of a pen. Lays down a very nice, thick and even patch of ink that is quite wet, which is the way I like it. As to flex, vintage 14K, it remains hard to beat. You get your nice line variation. I love it. And it's smooth too. It's not scratchy. It's not scraping across the paper. A fantastic nib. Did you notice I'm a little enthusiastic? Yeah, that's because this is awesome. Okay, look at that. Look at that. Look at no pressure versus a lot of pressure. That goes from pretty much fine to pretty much double broad. So I'm not complaining. Okay, reverse writing gets you a very fine, I would say this is definitely an extra fine line. It's more scratchy and it might run dry. It's not pleasant to use, but for one or two words, you know, if you need a fine line, that would work. Okay, so Eric, thanks a lot for sending me this pen. I have to say that I really enjoy it. This is a pen that I will be using with a lot of pleasure. You've got to love flex nibs, everybody knows that. And I think this is a particularly nice example that's also smooth. These pens are not that difficult to obtain, which is also very nice, and you can do all kinds of stuff with this. So, magnificent. Thanks a lot for the pen. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you thought this was useful, and I'll see you later. Bye bye.